Hi again, and welcome back to my channel. Alright, okay, just like this would be a quick video, a short video regarding my medical update about my Jones fracture. Remember last May 29, I had a fall accident in Binondo? Yeah, I missed the two steps of the stairs. Win kami nun actually. Unfortunately, I fell and had this fracture on my left foot. Okay, so let me narrate to you what really happened. Bali, pauwi na nga kami nun, no? We're on our way home. Kasama ko yung family ko. Me, my husband, and my two children. So, we're done shopping. And then, that time, palabas na kami ng 9-9-9-9. Wala naman akong biniblame. I blame myself because, yun nga, I opted to put my backpack sa harapan ko. And then, yun, it somehow distracted my vision. Yun, no? So I didn't notice na may dalawang steps, or dalawang, yun nga, may dalawang steps pa sa stairs. So, napababa. Yun, nagulat na lang ako. I wasn't already. I found myself like shouting, bug. And then, yun lang. Ang dalawang na nasa part. Ang sakit. Sobra. Ang tatang niya, oo, masakit. O ba nga, makapilo ka lang, inahulog pa. Nahulog ka pa, so ka lang, napakasakit. So I thought it was just a plain, you know, so, napipalot lang ba, o parang ganun, hindi eh. My left foot twisted talaga. So, yun. Ito na, ang pinatatakutan ko. Hindi ako makatayo at that time. I think I'm a heavyweight. Okay. So, mataba ako eh. So, yun. Hindi ako matayo. At hindi ko mapagtayo. I was trying to mayapak. Hindi ko mayapak. Tawag dito, ito na lang. Lumisponde agad yung lady guard na dun sa door. At the same time, very alert siya. Tinawagan niya. Tinulungan niya muna ako. Since di nga ako makatayo ng todo. Ayun. She called for the assistance na ng kanilang safety officer. Just put down their names on the description box below, pero I salute them for helping me out that time and giving me first aid that time. So they also referred to us to Sem Memorial Hospital, that's in Tayuman, but then that would be too far already from our place. In Las Piñas, so we opted to just go to the emergency ER of Las Piñas Doctor's Hospital para mas malapit na sa amin. Okay. So yun, sa madaling salita, to cut the story short, yung ginawa sa akin, thankful ako, thank you talaga sa mga tumulong sa akin from the building, staff ng building. Yung safety officer nila, si Kuya, talagang made a tentative or temporary na ano ko, parang tourniquet using a carton and then wrapping it with a packaging tape para lang hindi ko magalaw. Kasi sabi niya, ma'am, huwag niyo magalaw. Hindi natin alam yung extent ng pagtahulog niyo. So, yun. And true enough, syempre, on the first look, nakita niyo, syempre, namamaga. And then, para siyang may naka bukol yung sa side. Actually, yun nga pala, no? Jones fracture. So, lagay ko dito. Ano yung Jones fracture? And then, andyan yung ito. Yan yung ano ko. Yan yung body ko. Kita nyo sa, that's the printout of my x-ray. Okay, so yun. Kita nyo dyan. Yung aking, that's the fifth metatarsal bone. Yun yung nadali. Yun yung nagkaroon ng fracture. Yan yung buto na kumbaga nagdudugtong din sa hindiliit natin. So, the orthopedic doctor told me that it's called the Jones fracture. And, fail. There are only two ways to treat that, through casting, yung cast, hindi na sinisemento, no? Ito yung, I'll put down on this description, in the description box below din, kung ano yung ginamit sa akin cast. It's a modern cast na hindi na ito yung tipong white cement, yung sinisemento, tapos pinipirman ka, hindi na ganun. No? So actually, ito yun. No? Yun. Okay, talagang pinapintan. Anyway, put, lagay ko na din yung picture ito, yung picture ng cast. Okay, anyway, so yun na, going back. Two options, casting and surgery. Natural, syempre, considering our finances at the moment, I would go for casting. It cost us like 6,000. Okay, 6,000 pesos for casting. Syempre, yun, kasi ang surgery would cost us like around, good thing we didn't choose surgery because it would cost us 80 to 100,000. Okay, so no way. So maski sabihin ni Doc na mas faster yung healing, fast, mabilis din mawawala yung funds mo. Okay, so I might as well go for the crutches. So May 29 yun, ER scenario ganito. In-x-ray ako, nilipit ako sa sakit. Good thing I have a pain reliever. I took a leaf pain reliever. Yun muna, while on the way. Kasi grabe na po, nag-traffic pa kami almost 2 hours from Divisoria going to Los Pinos. So, just imagine the pain, the very uncomfortable na feeling ko. I stay champion in front para mas komportable ako. Pero just the same, I didn't feel comfortable at all with my condition that time. Syempre, ma-accident. Anyway, going back to the hospital. So, that's around, it was like around mag-8 na tayo ng gabi. 8 or, yeah, mag-8 na ng gabi. And then, nasisto ako, magpa-x-ray. Then, nagpa-x-ray, after that, syempre, di mo kagad makita yung resulta ng yung reading. So, ang ginawa lang ng doctor, pulled out the parang computer file lang nga, soft copy. Yung pinakita sa amin, extent ng, yun nga, may fracture. So, we are advised to see the ortho doctor sa hospital na yun the following day. And, unfortunately, wala na rin magka-cast that time. So, wala na yung ortho that is available that night. So, I really have to make tiis. Parang tiis ko yung hindi yung matinap kasi the doctor prescribed me naman an antibiotic for anti-inflammation sa pamamaga at saka sa adjusting yung sasakit. Continue ko lang daw yung iinom kong pain reliever. Okay, so yun. I took that medicine for 10 days, twice a day. Tama ba? Yeah, twice a day, every 12 hours. So, yun. Masakit, syempre, fresh pa na that time. So, syempre, sa pagkakahulo ko that time, pati yung ano ko naapektuhan, yung right leg ko. Good thing, hindi ako nabalian. Feeling ko na this, na pressure na ano na ano rin na parang siguro natagalan ko din kaya ang sakit din tumama rin siguro rin kasi yun madaling salita I really have to be on crutches saklay ako so gabi pa lang May 29 we bought the crutches already. Okay, so dun pa lang sa ER we spent 2,000 and mind you hindi mo ma pag outside patient ka. Tama ba yun? Outside patient. Outpatient ka, hindi mo siya makiklaim to feel him. Okay? Ang traumatic, ganyan pala, na accident, cannot be filed through feel him. Sad to say. Okay? So, yun. So, we spent 2,000 plus something. Basta, almost 2,100 for the ER and X-ray and yung ano daw assistance. And then we use the yun. Anyway, yun na yung initial. And then we bought the crutches for like almost 1,600 plus yung gamot ko. So no, roughly that night we spent 4,000. So yun. And then the following day, Tuesday, nandun pa lang yung doctor. Tama-tama, yun nga, check-up. Check-up was like, what's this? Yeah, 600. And 600 ang check-up. Pero, syempre, kailangan ko lang magpa-cast. Kailangan na siya, ano, so 6,000. Lahat-lahat. Kinast na. So, naman na siguro yung doctor na, hindi niya doon. So, anyway, 6,000 mo. That's it. Tapos, yung nangyari doon, after nyo, sabi na sa ni Doc, bawal basain, dapat maka-elevate, mas mataas sa heart elevation. Alam niyo yung pag napipilayan yung maka-elevate talaga yun, mataas, para ma-avoid yung malesan yung panamaga, tsaka yung pagmamanas. Bawal na masyadong matagal na paupo, matayo, isin. So, since I'm a makeup artist, on that time, I was preparing for my two events. For June, so May 29 ako na aksidente, June 3, may upcoming events ako. Dalawa, early morning wedding, at saka in the afternoon, mga debut, 2 p.m. yung call time ko. So I really had to ask for backup sa mga kalabwa ko, makeup artist na time. So yun. Fortunately, may nag-available. So no morning, it turned out well. And the bride, as well as the entourage, with the family, were very appreciative of what I did, because I showed up. And so yun, going back. The day turned out well. All of my clients were very happy that time, very happy with our services, with our team. At the end of the day, ito na. Syempre, normal lang yun. Maski hindi pa rin ako napipinunod, at the end of the day, pagod, makakapagod, syempre. Very fulfilling. Makakapagod ko, masaya. But then, iba'y kasi yung kalagayan ko ngayon. Nararamdaman ako that time. Like only 5 days. Fresh na fresh pa yung sakit ng paa ko. Kaya that time masakit din yung right leg ko kasi napupunta yung bigat ko doon, yung weight ko, yung pressure doon sa ankle ko, sa right leg ko. Sumasakit talaga. Ilang araw ko siyang tiniinis. So, from May 29, it has already been 21 days na naka-patches ako, mag-wheelchair ako. So yun. I bought a wheelchair then. So hindi ko pinanginayaan yun. I bought it for 4,200 including the delivery charge. From Lazada ko binili. Eventually we'll be sending it naman din. So yun, it's maganda yung klase niya. Very lightweight compared to other na bakal talaga yung iba. So yun, going back to dun sa ano ko. So ngayon, ano ba yung experience ko during yung first weeks or 14 days? I really adjusted a lot. Because yun, to the point that I watched videos on how to use the crutches, I oriented myself in how to use it. When you're gonna watch it on the video, it's kala mo, dali-dali. Pero pag ikaw na, ako na, ang hirap. Because dapat ang weight hindi na sa armpit o sa kilikilo. Dapat nandun siya sa weight ng hawakan ng crutches. So, dapat meron kang 2 inches allowance from your armpit pag ginagamit mo sa kulay. Para hindi ka rin makaroon ng back concerns or mga scoliosis sa kutawin niyo. Yun, hirap talaga, grabe. Dun sa pinagdaanan ko, emotionally, I was really affected. Even my family got affected. Sa pagiging masunipos, dahil naramdaman ako, gusto ko, paglinutos ako, and then kaagad kasi hindi ako makakilos eh. Na makakilos. It taught me patience. Talaga. And, you know, daily, I always apologize to my, syempre sa mga kapamilya ko, apologize to my family, for sa kasunitan ko, then, ganun may naramdaman ko, but then, tutunin natin na ba yung natin nagsuspeak kasi sila din nahihirapan. And hindi din namin ginusto pare-pare ng nangyari sa akin. So, and then, at the end of the day, I say sorry and then thank them as well. So, for my family, thank you so much for your support in the midst of my condition, present condition. You're still there to support me. Hindi niyo ako pinabayaan. So, yung dyan maski, nakakainisan na tayo, nakakairitahan na tayo. So, yun, maraming fans. Sino mahal na mahal ko yun. My husband, to my 2 children, I love you so much. I love you dearly. Always remember that, ha? Pasensya na yun si mama. Babes, pasensya talaga. Sorry guys, if I'm telling this to the video right now because grabe, I'm so grateful to have a family like them. And you know what? Ano yung saan ako kumukuha ng lakas sa pamilya ko. Because I really need to heal, recover soon. Siyempre, you know, I lifted myself up to the Lord for healing. And believe me or not, last week I had this midweek service. I just watched this, the free chapel midweek service. After that, I really felt good, and from there was this instant healing. It was just the day before my x-ray, scheduled x-ray last week. Okay. 2 days before, that was like, by the way, to help me relieve the pain during the first 2 weeks, I used this Bengay pain relieving cream. Because I don't want to take too much, oral medication for pain. So I put this non-basic pain, and it's really good. Yeah, it's mentholated actually. Yeah, it's Bengay pain relieving cream. Then with the aid of this ball roller, I bought this at Miniso. My mom actually shared this. So, yun, bumili na din kami. So, it's really good in massaging. Karatis mabuhay, buhay ulit yung dugo ko. Lalo na dito pagpagising at sa mga gasyan, kung magdala ka na magdala tayo nakahiga. So, wala parang tumigil yung blood circulation. It helps in blood circulation ulit. So, yun. Actually, mami ko nga ginagamit ito pang ano ko yun. Mataba dito. Oo nga naman. Pwede rin. Anyways, ayun. I use this tool. It aids in relieving my pain as well sa legs. So, 2 days before, I had my... 2 days before, so that's Wednesday and then came Saturday. Then ako nagpa follow-up x-ray. Okay, sa hospital. Okay, I paid ₱930 for the x-ray. Okay, and then I had to go back tomorrow for my check-up, for my follow-up check-up to see the doctor again. Just imagine the expenses and hassle and pain. Good thing it's not that too serious, but then, it's a minor thing. I draw my strength from my, from my family. Siyempre, I also watch videos na makita ko yung mga tapos manulatin si Crush yung sa akin, naputulan ng paano kamay na yun, so parang sabi ko, kakayanin ko, and I claim all, I claim healing for this, because 6 to 8 weeks ang healing process ng bone structure. Alright, so yun. So, I mentioned to you that it affected me emotionally, mentally, yes. Because dumating sa point na paano to, ang paningkips ko, future needs. But then, God is so good. Pag hindi ka-equip na gawin ko isang bagay ito, meron siyang binibigay na blessing. And I'm also a seller and a manufacturer. Kami nang usapan ng mga vanity mirrors. So, praise God for divine connections. We're able to get new vanity orders sa online. So, yun. And God is just so good to, you know, He's really a good provider, si Lord. No, sa families natin, alam mo pag natin dadaan ng ganito, alam niya yung pangangailan natin, hindi niya sa pangangailan. Minsan, mahiya ka nga dahil despite na nakakamali tayo, nakakasala tayo, then He's always there for us. No. So He's there for us to guide us, to protect us, reminding us to, you know, go back. Just praise and worship Him. Yeah, in the middle of your concerns, of your problems, and yeah, there's really the power in the name of Jesus, and there's power when you pray to Him, when you give up your concerns all to Him. Okay, so yun. Anyway, that's basically it for now. I'm good. I'm doing good. I'm slowly recovering. Lately I've been doing makeup tutorials, like for this look, kanina lang. I'll show that in a different video. For this look, and going back to my situation, don't worry about me, I'm good, and I know if ever you, and I just pray for you, all of you out there, I pray for protection. Always remind, tao lang tayo, be very careful at all times, wherever you go, wherever you are, walking pa kang kante, be alert, para maiwasan yung mga aksidente na yan. Okay? Sabi nga, maging ano tayo. This is, may tawag ko. Hindi tayo dapat alisto. Okay? Take precautionary measures. Okay? Mga ganyan. And, always be ready. In any problems, parating patalo lang si Lord. Wala nga iba. Okay? Huwag kayo makikinig doon sa mga hindi maganda yung sasabihin sa inyo ng God. Dahil lalo lang, that would really pull you down. Don't get pulled down by those people na yan, kasi parang tatanong ko na, sure, and then. So, wala naman ang ganda sa akin. Okay, so, ano yung sabihin ko lang ito? Para mas mabilis kang tumaling, you really need people around us that would really care for us, know our situation, and be more, you know, being sensitive sa sitwasyon ng disabled persons like me. Okay, sayo. So yun. I think that's basically it for now, and hopeful and prayerful and with deep conviction that I am going to, and actually I am healed. I am healed. I am the healed of the Lord, and I'm claiming that. Now, whatever yung nararamdaman ko ngayon, my right leg is perfect right now, perfect in perfect condition. That's why I can move around faster, and I can, since yesterday or the other day, I started not to use my wheelchair kasi most of the time, ginagamit wheelchair ko going to and from sa bathroom ngayon. As much as possible, I walk on my crutches, so para at least na-exercise din ako. Yeah, and then by the time I am fully recovered, I'll slowly, Lord, help me, Lord, with my family, na, you know, to lose weight. I really need to lose weight because I'm not getting any younger. Okay, I think that's basically it. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you on my next video. Alright? Thank you. God bless you always. Take care. No matter what, always look up to Him. Just give Him praises and all the glory and honor. Thank you so much. God bless you.